people, welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Sir P. Now, welcome back to the real life movie that is called Jamaica. Today I'm going to talk about three things. I'm going to talk about the businessman with them wet up in the churchyard. Then I'm going to talk about the two young puppy show them that tried to impersonate police again. Right? Then I'm going to talk about the teacher that we didn't catch and impersonate the police, because some more information come out now and some people have been reaching out to me and telling me about this brother. Right, so I'm going to talk about those at the end. But let me start off with this businessman. Now, people, man by the name of Wayne Stanbury, right, must have come from what I said, catching. Now, apparently, the man in Detroit wet him up last year, October, right, what him get away, right? Apparently over 20 odd rounds going at the car, and the only thing happened to him was a graze on his finger. Now, it seems that he had relocated to Kingston to get away from St. Catherine. Although, in my opinion, that is not exactly a very long drive, or that is not exactly a huge relocation, because Kingston and St. Catherine literally the right side and side. So if you are planning to get it from St. Catherine, Kingston is the last place me to go. Right, I'd be looking to head to the western part of the island, and to be honest, nowhere in Jamaica no far. Nowhere in Jamaica no far. Right, so if you and man not things and you are left St. Catherine and you think say I go a town and that I go stop them, as this case shows, that is a very fatal mistake on your part. Right, now it turns out the man had pulled up the church, right, and as he was coming out of him car, the man named Pounce upon him in the churchyard and wet him up. Now, as I was reading the story on the social media, you know, I was checking out the various newspaper sites who were posting the story, and you know, people in the comment section, and everybody in the comment section kept saying the same thing. Can't believe them do this. Then do this team at the churchyard. Me can't believe them do this at the church and they respect the church. And I'm like, what are these people talking about? Look how long Jamaicans stop respect church. People, stop the foolishness. Stop the foolishness. Jamaica as a culture hasn't been respecting church, mosque, synagogue, whatever on Wango, Bobo Hill. Jamaica as a culture no respect nothing for the last 20 years. What are you talking about? When they go in a dance and the favorite artist, they say him run to the church and wait up, wait you up all if you stand up next to the person. Down the bus blank, boom, 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 big tune. And smile. So what the problem? All of a sudden you don't respect church? Because no one is seen in a real life, all of a sudden people, oh, you need to respect church. People, stop the foolishness. Stop the foolishness. Okay? Now, this man was the operator of a prominent financial services business in a St. Catherine. Now, when I saw that, my antennas immediately went off. Now, of course, let me make it clear, I don't even want a simple Simon jump in, right? I am not suggesting this have nothing to do with the financial, quote-unquote, financial services business we have. I'm not saying I know why the man named with him up. No, I never did it, simple Simon. And none of the man them who do it didn't call me and tell me why them do it, right? But I'm just saying, when I saw owner of financial services business, and me know sound on the NCB and a Sagicor, my antennas immediately went up, because people, we have to understand, St. Catherine is home to a lot of these quote-unquote financial services. A matter of fact, a lot of people didn't know that the welder, yes, the welder that is currently down at Horizon right now, none other than Tesha Miller, actually owned one of these prominent financial services businesses. Enough people didn't know that. And again, before me go any further, I'm not linking the two. I'm just saying St. Catherine, full of these financial services businesses. And enough of them, they basically niche money lenders. You lend them, you borrow money from them, and then lend it back to you at a much higher rate than what the bank would ask for. And the reason why them interest rate higher is because the people who go to them are normally people who can't get something through the bank, and I guess are higher risk So they normally charge a higher interest. So all I'm saying is, if I was JCF, if I was an investigator in JCF, that's one of the places where I would start to look first. What kind of customer, disgruntled customer, or who get who this, or who should I get that and didn't get that. That's one of the first places I would start, right? Now, the fact say, the man them go for him last year, October, and then come back for him now, show you that they are very determined, right? Them even follow him got tone. So, again, people, it's probably something to do on money or something like that. But I'm sure further on down the road, we're going to hear about this case. Now, let me move on to the case involving the two young youth them, right, who them catch and impersonate police people. Them say the man them go through a checkpoint, right? Listen to this story again and tell me if Jamaica is not a living movie, a real life movie, right? The man them go through a checkpoint, right? Police, obviously, it's a checkpoint, so police are like, stop them, blah blah blah, wagwan. When the police them start questioning them, the man them go tell the police them, say, oh, don't worry yourself, man. We are police. We are members of the JCF. Police are like, okay, give me some ID then. When the man them reach them ID and show them, police them instantly realize that it's a Mickey Mouse ID. A cartoon ID. This can't be real thing. Right? Then when time they run two numbers now, make two calls. It turn out, say, the car them where the man them drive. At least the man them leave the car. Right? People, imagine this. The car get thief all the way in a sea view. Right? Sea view. Right? And you mean to tell me, say, them youth, no wish part of the checkpoint them there. Right? The car was a Mazda Primacy. The man them no wish part of the checkpoint there. And still try to go through the checkpoint with a car with them thief and a Mickey Mouse police ID. People, tell me, say, Jamaica is not a movie. This have to be a show. How can one of them was 18 and one was 17, right? So young youth them, right? So just like with the other case, you scratch your head and I wonder why you're going to a police station with an illegal machine by you. Now you have to wonder to yourself, why you try to go through a checkpoint with a thief in car and a Mickey Mouse ID? And you notice it happened right after the other case when you realize that in Jamaica there's a lot of copycat crimes. As soon as I hear about one type of crime, within 3 days, hear about something very similar. You notice every time you hear some man with a woman and with himself, within 3 days, you hear it again. It's like, it's almost as if people in Jamaica are sitting and wait for hear a story and say, all right, I'm going to do something similar now. It's very strange, right? Very strange. And speaking about impersonating officers, we could go back to the case with the teacher, right? People, some of these teachers, past students have been messaging me and telling me about this brother. And everybody who messaged me so far has described a similar person. Them say, from them I got a school, them realize that this brother ain't have no head. Them say, from them I got a school, them realize that this brother head can't good. Right? Because some of the things, apparently he was a drama teacher. Some of the things he had those boys doing. Right? Them say, he never make no sense to them at the time. Right? And next thing that people highlight to me is that the name of the ID, right? The name of the machine license where them find at the house belonged to another teacher that apparently was taken out. He was a teacher at Vauxhall, right? Or them take him out at Vauxhall, right? And people have been telling me that, oh, that was the same name of a teacher who did have a license machine and them take him out at Vauxhall. Now we have to start asking the question, why was this teacher in possession of a machine license for a man who got taken out? Did that teacher play a role in that man getting taken out? Or does he know somebody who did it? Or when I'm corrupt police bridging them, find the man body and realize that he have the ID and have the machine license body, and them say, hey, you know, so we can get a machine license for your seat here. People, you have to start scratch your head. It can go anywhere. Those are the things I'm looking at. Either he played a role in it, he knows who did it and the person gave it, or when I'm corrupt police bridging them, take it off of the man body and give it to him. Right, I'm have some links to my FLA. The point is, this can't done just so. Right, this story is bigger than just some madded one gone down the station. I hope the investigator them no left no stones unturned. But people, I'm telling you, this story, right? Even though we are laughing and I say, oh, he made no good, this story is much, much bigger, people. Most of them find over 30 spank shell. 30 spank shell and license for machine that belonged to a man that got taken out. This brother here need to have some serious investigation drop on him. And if, as I said, people, the man that are school are teach. This shows you the system that we have. This man was in the system teaching young men, teaching students. These are the people who could get under the system news. He had the schools full and he had other police full. I wonder if you realize the movie that we live in. Jamaica is not an island. Jamaica is not a country. Jamaica is a movie. Why, oh boy. Patreon squad, big up himself. Please like, comment, and share the video. Bless.